KMES English Medium Junior College welcomes its students for online lecture of psychology for standard 12. For the chapter 8, Memory. For the topic, Measurements of Memory. Measurement of Memory. Students, we have learned that memory can be measured. So, retention can be measured using different methods. Some of the major ways of measuring memory are recall, recognition, and relearning. Let us learn each of these memory measuring ways in detail. Recall can be in a written form or it can be oral. Again, recall can be free recall or serial recall. So, recall is a method where the individual has to reproduce some previously learned material with few or no retrieval cue. It requires word-for-word memory. Recall is retrieval of information from long-term memory with few or no cue. The essay type question which appears in the exam is an example of recall. Recall involves remembering a fact, event or object that is not currently physically present and require a direct recovery of the information from memory. Mukdog in 1962 did one experiment to check the recall of the subject. He asked subject to learn a list of words. Later, the recall was tested by the free recall method. Mukdog found that subject could recall first few primary effects and the last few recency effect words. But they got confused with the word in the middle part, serial position effect. Recall is of two types. It is free recall and serial recall. Free recall, it is recollection of the item in the list without a serial order. Memory for free recall is always better if the subjects are asked to recall in serial order. Free recall is effective in studying primary recency effect. Primary effect occurs when a subject is able to recall items which are present at the starting point of the list. And recency effect occurs when a subject is able to recall the items which are present at the end. So, primary effect, the initial item of the list are easily remembered due to transfer of to the long-term memory through rehearsal. Whereas, recency effect, the final list item of the list can be recalled better as they are still in the short-term memory. Example of pre-recall is when we listen to a lecture and afterwards recall few important points irrespective of the order in which they are presented. Coming to the second type of record, serial record. Here material is recalled in the exact order in which it was presented. If you watch a dance show and if you were asked about when, who presented first and who was second performer and so on, here your answer will be in serial order. When we solve a mathematical problem like 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 and 4 into 4 is equal to 16, you are doing step 1 after the other, so it is a serial record. Recall is greatly influenced or affected by emotions and motivation at the time of learning and at the time of retrieval also. Recognition. It refers to the act of identifying something that has already been learned or affirming some material as being familiar. For example, multiple choice, true or false, matched, paired types of questions. The subject is asked to learn a list of items. Then he is presented another list containing the items from the first list along with other items. You have to identify items learned from the initial list. So, recognition. In this method, the individual has to point out or recognize previously learned material which are presented to him in a different context. They already learn material in the present and the learner has to recognize it. It becomes relatively easier than the recall method. Using the score of memory by recognition method is more than the recall method. Examples of recognition are multiple questions or matched records. Recognition score can be obtained by the formula. Recognition score is equal to right response minus wrong response upon total into 100. Recognition depends on the factors like practice and attention into detail. Generally, recognition tends to be easier than recall due to the presence of cue.
Relearning. It measures retention by measuring how much faster one learns a previous learned material after an interval of time. The comprehension of retention score at the time of first learning and the second learning shows that there is improvement in terms of time, number of trials taken, etc. Thus, by relearning, there is saving of time taken to learn the same material. This method is also known as saving method. The same material is learned by the same subject up to a same learning criteria on two different occasions separately by some time interval. It measures memory by comparing which include performance on the same task on two different occasions.
So, relearning method or the method of saving. The subject is made to learn something a second time, either from hour or day, after the original learning. Relearning refers to the speed with which a subject can learn the learned material for a second time.
The amount of retention is different in number of trials and time taken from the original learning and learning. So the saving score is equal to original learning trial minus relearning trial upon original learning trial into 100. Factors that affect relearning are meaningfulness of a material, the degree of original learning, and the general ability of a person. Generally, relearning is better indicator than recall or recognition.